各位好，欢迎收看中国电视荧屏上首个电视青年公开课，开讲了。今天与众不同，今天是我做开讲的节目这么长时间以来第一次，在我说话的时候就有人欢呼，尽管我知道这个欢呼声不是给我的。当别人问我说你喜欢什么运动的时候，我会很骄傲地说篮球 basketball。 但是每次当我说完这句话以后，对方的表情感觉就好像我爱上了一项不应该爱上的运动。但是我一直到今天都没有放弃，我始终在心里告诉自己，总有一天，总有一天你会和这个世界上最好的篮球运动员站在同一个舞台上。今天是一个梦想实现的日子，请看大屏幕。
他手持篮球，速度惊人，投篮精准，天下无双。一身24号紫金战袍，人称黑曼巴小飞侠。有人视他为魔鬼，有人说他是神话，他就是 NBA 国际巨星科比布莱恩特，一个在篮球界让人畏惧的男人。17岁进入 NBA， 18岁成为史上最年轻的扣篮冠军。他对胜利有着极端的渴望，他对冠军有近乎偏执的狂热。他说只要我还在打篮球，我就想拿下冠军。与其说他是一位伟大的球星，不如说他代表一种独有的精神，能力，野心，永不言弃。
做好准备了吗？掌声有请我们的开讲嘉宾 Kobe Bryant。
Thank you. That's an incredible welcome. You know, makes me feel right at home. Thank you.
I 期盼这个时刻期盼了很久，但是当这个时刻真正到来的时候，我却又无比的纠结，因为我不知道明天出现在网络上的照片会是什么样的。他们会放一个科比的照片，然后说萨比宁就在旁边。You're so kind.
Thank you.
You're a good man. 但是很多事情是没法改变的，镜头照顾不到就是照顾不到，把镜头给他吧。
Thank you.
来中国也有很多次了，前前后后走过了中国的，到目前应该有14个城市了。目前中文怎么样？能简单的说一点点中文吗？
I can say 你好， I can say 谢谢， and I can say 好久。
就他的中文让我想起小沈阳说我的英文名叫小沈阳。这个尽管发音还不是特别标准，这就是同声传译的问题。就我每次一说完他得过一会儿，哈哈。所以你不介意的话，我想教你一个中文单词。
OK，
好吗？你知道你的名字用中文怎么说吗？ 他会吓一跳。
Oh, he's gonna have me say something else. It just does not mean my name.
肯定是你的名字，请注意听我的发音。
Okay.
科比·布莱恩特。
科比·布莱恩特。
对。
I gotta try again.
You gotta
do it again.
布莱恩特。
布
莱
莱
恩
恩
特
特。
科比布莱恩。
科比布莱恩特。
这可能也是第一次大家听到科比用中文说自己的名字。以后你到其他的地方，你就可以介绍 I am 科比布莱恩特。你这人会 crazy。接下来这个问题，我是代表所有的关心你的球迷，包括我自己问你，伤好了一些没有？
I'm getting better. It's close. Like I don't know if they can see the scar. See, I still have the scar right there. I'm getting better. So like right now I can hop over my toes and so it's a good sign. Yeah, it's a good sign. I'm gonna be back at 100%.
对。所有球迷最想说的，希望你能够早一点康复，回到篮球场上，继续追逐你的梦想。
Thank you， 谢谢。
现在咱们坐下说。
Oh, thank you，
好不好？ Wow. 你们是非要看着我爬上去是吗？我告诉你，我不会屈服的。你有一个球迷叫周杰伦。
Yeah, of course, I know Jay Chou.、Yeah.
他篮球打得怎么样？说实话。
He is. He's very good. He dribbles very well. He knows how to do all the tricks behind the back, between the legs. He's actually very good.
你觉得他的篮球和他的歌比哪一个更好？
I'd probably say his song.
所以明天我们的头版头条，科比认为周杰伦还是不要打篮球了。其实我这个问题是有陷阱的。他如果说啊，周杰伦其实篮球打得可以啊，第二天报纸又出来了，周杰伦不适合唱歌。但是周杰伦也说了，说打篮球科比可以教我，但是有一件事儿我可以教科比，那就是我可以教科比开讲。不信大家看。
很开心科比要上这个开讲的这个节目，相信很多同学呢对你都非常的好奇。你说科比平常除了打篮球之外，喜欢听什么歌，看什么电影，有没有？我觉得平常的休闲娱乐是什么？除了打篮球之外哦，当然呢，打篮球这一块也非常重要，因为光打篮球可以让全世界都可以认识你，我觉得这个非常不简单。你的奋斗过程啊，相信有很多可以分享给这些同学们，带给他们正能量的。在这边呢，祝你这个开讲成功，加油！
他们当中有很多人也同样是周杰伦的歌迷，而且我知道你跟周杰伦合作唱过一首歌。对
yeah, yeah,
尽管在那首歌里科比好像就唱了几个词，但是科比给自己那首歌的演绎打的是 A 加。
You don't want me singing that song, man. I'm terrible at singing.
我们太想听了。
No, I can't sing. I don't even remember the words to the song me and Jay Chou sang.
把你最想说的话用这种音乐的方式能告诉他吗？
I'll do the musicYou can do the word.
Okay, 好。24号科比，身高1.98米，在场上是绝佳的后卫。他的绝杀是后仰跳投，面对他，没有人敢说自己是老大。经过很多年，他做了很多事，他得了很多冠军，他但是不罢休。他仍然还想奋斗，他还想打，他的目标可能是下一个6连冠、6连冠、7连冠、8连冠，永远场上的王者，科比。
We're gonna make an album next. We're gonna make an album, me and you.
你觉得我的词基本上正确吗？你的目标是七连冠、八连冠。
I understood every word and I thought it was incredible.
你打算拿多少次冠军才够呢？
When I first started playing, my goal was to always win 7. For whatever reason, I felt like that was something that I wanted to go after, and it's still the case.
真正一个天生为竞争、为篮球而生的人，在他心目中只有下一个冠军。接下来我们进入到科比最想聊的一个话题 ，Black Mamba， 黑曼巴。让他和我们分享一下他心目中黑曼巴的精神。
Am I supposed to talk now? Black Mamba. Black Mamba is one of the deadliest snakes in the world. And, you know, the reason why I got the name is because when I step on the basketball court, that's what I become. So, you know, off the court, you know, I'm laughing, joking, and fun. And once I get on the court, then that's when I become this other person, this other thing. It helps me focus.Now I'll be 35, and you know the end of the career is much closer than the beginning was. And then I have an injury like this happen to me, and it just feels like you know you feel like everything just comes to a stop. And it wasn't a knee injury, it wasn't a shoulder injury. It was an injury that a lot of people have lost their careers on. It's an injury that some people have had.They've never come back the same. And, you know, at that moment, it became a time where I had to look in the mirror. And I had to say to myself, all right, you know, Kobe, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? Because a lot of people are saying you can't come back. I know what kind of injury this is. I've seen people not come back. And I had to look myself in the mirror and say, okay, now it's time to step up. It's time to step up. I don't know if I'm going to come back from it.Like, as I sit here with you now, I'm telling you, I'll come back 100%. But I don't know for sure. You know, I have moments and I have days where I doubt myself. But to me, that's the exciting part of the challenge. And that's when I realized, you know, this is a great opportunity to come out and show everybody this is how you bounce back. This is how you respond to a challenge. And the people who say, you'll never do it, you'll never make it, this is how I look at that.The people that say you will never come back from this injury, to me, that means that if they had this injury, they would quit. That's what that means to me. Because if they sit there and look at me and say, I can't do it, that means if this happened to you, you wouldn't do it. You know? So, I have to show them just as much as I show the people who are supporting me.That this can be done, and this can, you know, I can't come back from this. And by me coming back from this shows the people who doubt me, hopefully it makes them reconsider what's possible. And I think that's the important story about the scar. And, you know, a scar is nothing but a good story anyway. So. It's a passion of mine to try to win because it's the hardest thing in team sports to do is to win the championship. And as a competitor, you want to go after that which you feel is the biggest challenge. And the biggest challenge is how do you take a group of individuals and help them become one and get to the top of that mountain again and again and again. And that's the biggest challenge in team sports, and that's why...I love going after it. Well, I think that the The important thing for me has always been responding to challenges, not being afraid of those challenges. But more importantly, it's always been a constant curiosity of how to get better and how to be better and where to learn from. So, you know, even to this day, I mean, I can go back to when I was a kid and I always looked for inspiration from everywhere, not just Michael Jordan or Magic Johnson, but, you know, also from, you know, Michael Jackson, from, you know, from Beethoven, from Leonardo da Vinci, from Bruce Lee, from, you know, it was just so many different people that I try to look to and I try to learn from. And I think that's really the biggest thing about having the Mamba mentality. It's not necessarily, you know, being ultra competitive or being ultra aggressive, but it's really about wanting to learn. And feeling like your cup is always empty because there's always more that you can fill it with. That's really the important thing, is just continuing to learn, seek out knowledge, talk to other people, and not feel like you have all the answers. And I think because of that, you wind up getting better, you wind up improving, and then as a byproduct, you wind up, you know, winning maybe a little bit more than some of your competitors, hopefully. But that's what the Mamba mentality really stands for. That's the beginning of what that attitude stands for. And if I can use some of the basketball experience that I've had to pass it on to some of you guys, and no matter what you do, if you want to be a basketball player, you want to be a writer, you want to be a TV host, whatever it is that you want to do, it's making sure that you focus with laser-like precision on that goal. And you learn from other people who have been great, because no matter what they're doing, there's always a common thread. There's always a common denominator between what has made people great and what separates good from great. And you know, that's the message that I'm carrying to you guys today. Thank you.
既然你对黑曼巴如此了解，请看大屏幕。以上四种蛇，哪一种是黑曼巴
？Okay. Well,
A B C D.
Yeah, I'm going to say C.
C. Yeah. Why?
Well, because the black mamba, actually, the snake itself isn't black. It's like an olive color.But the reason why it's called black mamba is because you see the inside of its mouth is ink black. That's where it gets its name from. If you see the inside of a black mamba's mouth, you're in trouble.
Exactly. See, 黑曼巴确实太有攻击性了。就这个蛇，我看一眼我都觉得浑身汗毛倒竖。再请看下一道题。以上四种动物，哪一种黑曼巴不吃？A, B, C, D.
I'm probably going to say a bat will be pretty hard to get. A bat's going to be pretty hard to get. I'll say C.
C. 蝙蝠
probably eats all of them, but I'll say C.
Why?
Black mambas don't fly.
黑曼巴不飞，对，但是蝙蝠会落下来啊。B, 同样也会飞。
Oh, man, yeah, that thing. Well, let's say, I'll say B.
科比，我能看出来他在学校考试。如果他要身边有个同学啊，给他答案，哎呦，这可能是 B, C, 不对，可能是 C, C. 确定吗
？Yeah, B, final answer.
Final answer.
B, final answer.
让我们来看看正确答案。
I've actually seen it eat a bat before. I'll say B.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
It's just the right one.
Yeah, they don't live in the same place.
蛇鹫，这种动物叫蛇鹫，不但黑曼巴不吃它，反而它是黑曼巴的天敌。如果它发现黑曼巴，它会从空中俯冲下来。对黑曼巴造成威胁。接下来我想问的就是，在 NBA 的球场上，或者在你走过的世界这么多球场上，你碰到过蛇鹫吗？你的克星和天敌？
I'm not afraid of anything when I compete. But there are a lot of.
I mean, 好有霸气的答案。
No, no. I mean, there's nothing to be afraid of because, you know, the purpose of for me in playing and also living is to challenge things. It's to be competitive. To see what you can do. And if you don't win, you know, that's fine. You learn from it and then you come back again. You know, so I'm not afraid of competition. I'm not afraid of anybody.
接下来，我知道科比，篮球是他的生命，能给我一个球吗
？Outro，Outro。
对不起，我知道我这样会让你们极为的不满和妒忌，但是我想请科比先生教我一下他的绝杀动作。
Okay, yeah, so, so fadeaway is just you, it's important that you have good balance. You want to lean back this way, put this leg up like this, like that. So lean back. Yeah, hey. Yes. That's really good. That's really good. Now you gotta snap it. So you gotta snap the wrist. Yep. That's perfect. Perfect. That's great. Perfect.
当然，篮球我是没法挑战科比。科比是一个非常喜欢竞争的人，在任何场合下他都不会轻易的认输，所以今天在这儿我们考他一下好不好？来过中国这么多次，只要你跟科比挑战关于球的问题，他都可以接受。我非常的坏，我拿了一个球，这个球是中国人非常擅长的乒乓，但是我们不用拍子打，我们用筷子。你会用筷子吗？Very good. OK， 接下来用筷子把乒乓球夹到这个碗里。
OK。
OK。
哦哦。
谁先夹完？谁先夹完？谁就是这个项目的 MVP。
Black Mamba。
好，我就和科比共同完成一下这项挑战。3, 2, 1, 0。
That's a good feeling, boy. It's cool. It's okay, man. It's all right, man. Beginner's luck. Beginner's luck, man. It's all right.
这是我人生中最耻辱和黑暗的一段。再次感谢科比接受我的挑战，并且赢得了这项挑战。谢谢。我要声明的是，我绝对没有一点点让着科比。我真的没发挥好。我真的没发挥好。接下来我们前排八位青年代表，我们一个一个来分享他们的问题。谁先开始？玛丽。
你好科比，感谢你的演讲。我在您的演讲中能看到决心、欲望以及野心。有三个时间 三个年份对您是非常重要的。在您十七岁的时候，你直接从高中进入了 NBA， 那么在25岁的时候，你已经拿下了三个总冠军，而在现在，也就是35岁，你正在经历一个职业生涯的低谷，在经历整个伤病的一个困扰。那么我的问题是，我们抛开篮球去不去说，仅仅是去谈您在17岁、25岁、35岁这样三个关键的年份，您对人生、对世界有什么样认识上的不同？谢谢。
Yeah, there's a lot of changes. It's a great question. There's a lot of changes. I think from a professional standpoint, from a basketball standpoint, the thing that at this age you have to guard against is being retrospective. Because, you know, because I'm injured, and because I've had a lot of success already, you want to start thinking about the successes that you've had. Oh man, yeah, you know, I won this one, I won that one, oh, it was great. But what that does is that makes you complacent. And you're not thinking ahead, you're not thinking of the next one. So I'm constantly fighting with myself, no, don't think about that yet, it's not time yet. There will come a time where I'll be retrospective, now's not that time. And then secondly, with my family, is that I was very fortunate to marry a woman who's just as competitive as I am. Who's just as competitive as I am in every facet and wants to do things right and wants to, you know, see us be successful. And one of the lessons that we try to teach our kids is that same work ethic, the same determination, the same drive. And so it's important that they see how hard I'm working and everything that goes into me coming back from this injury. Because if I just quit, if I roll over and quit and don't come back from this injury, what am I teaching them? Right? So, you know, as a parent, being 35 years old, being a husband, those are some of the things that I think about. One of the things that, you know, I try to do and what we had our kids do, actually, we just had a family vacation. Okay, so we go to Italy. I speak Italian. My kids don't. And so I would tell them, try to speak. They say, no, we don't want to speak. Try. No. Why won't you try? Oh, because it's going to sound, blah, blah, blah. And I said, no, it doesn't matter how you sound. You can't learn if you don't try. So it's, you know, like earlier, I sound like a complete idiot when I was trying to say my name is Kobe Bryant earlier. But you got to try.
Teach him how to call you father in Chinese. It's Baba. Okay.
Baba.
Yeah.
That I can do. I'll try. You know, it's, they actually have a Mandarin class in school.
Okay.
That they'll be taking this year. So we'll see. I mean, I'll never force my kids to do something, but if they do it and they enjoy it and they like it, then they can continue on.
Great.
All right, good.
下一位，杨志。
Hello, Kobe. You know, maybe you don't know. In China, your fans called you boss. In Chinese, 老大。老大你好。我是你的忠实粉丝。
这就成一个组织了啊。
对，然后我来自北京邮电大学，我叫杨振。然后呢，在我学校里，我有个小小的称号。叫北邮科比，
他是哪个学校的科比
？You know why？ 请看大屏幕。
这是你吗？
对 ，Good move, man.
Yes.
但还不如不看呢。开玩笑的，他是国家篮球二级运动员，中国的。
对，这些年来呢，我也看出来你很多的变化。从曾经的比较偏向于单打独斗，现在更偏向于倾向团队合作。那么是什么促使你这些变化的？曾经那个与世界为敌的科比，是否已经向世界开始妥协了呢
？Yeah, no. What you do is you learn. You learn. So when you start playing, you view things one way. But then you have to continue to learn. You have to continue to grow. You have to continue to get better.You know, this goes back to what I said earlier, is that you have to make sure that your cup is always empty. And you're always learning on how to get better, how to improve. And that's what I tried to do. So I always said, like, I was born to be a scorer, but then I learned how to become a winner. And that's why I've had that evolution.
篮球是一个集体项目。如果科比永远只知道单打独斗，那可能对于所有的球迷来讲将会是一件悲伤的事，但是现在的科比学会团队合作，我觉得这对于任何一个球员来讲都是成熟而不是妥协。下一位， 周恒。
科比先生您好，我是来自虎扑体育网的一位篮球记者，我在之前也报道过您的《中国行》，在几个月前，我在网上在报纸上看到了一个故事，一个孩子13岁了，特别喜欢打篮球，但是3岁那年，车祸让他失去了双腿，然后一次意外让他没办法像正常孩子那样打篮球，但是他依然在坚持，从来没有说过放弃篮球，我很感动。当我了解到他的偶像是科比·布莱恩特的时候，我决定，从网络上，从微博上发起一场爱心行动，然后去让他圆了这个梦想，见到科比先生您。然后今天，我也把他带到了我们现场。How are you？
他崇拜你，崇拜的不得了。现在你是他的，不光是篮球上的偶像，你可以说是他的一种精神的动力。有什么话想跟科比说？现在是最好的机会，说吧，大胆的说。
我呢，现在是一名不算太专业的运动员，但是我呢想接受你的训练，即使是凌晨4点。
科比的指导。
对，
现在最想让他教你什么？
投篮。
对，
投篮。
是。
你给科比示范一下你目前的投篮。
Perfect。
Center.
Perfect shot. And you know, I would say he has learned from what he has gone through, and the determination that he showed to come at and still want to play, and not give up on his dream, right?That lesson right there, that is what makes people successful, is to be able to go through adversity, to face adversity, and to not be afraid of it, not shy away from it, to not run from it, but instead to embrace it and take on that challenge. That's something that a lot of people just never ever learn. And he was tough enough to deal with that, and that's success.
我一辈子都会记得这个孩子那一瞬间的眼神，我觉得他没有看到科比，那一瞬间他根本没有看到科比，他看到的是他心里的一个梦突然变成真的了。在这一瞬间，很多人没有勇气，但是有勇气迈出第一步的就是英雄。所以现在科比是你心目当中的英雄，但与此同时，我希望你在你心里的英雄的名单里面再加上一个人，就是你自己。我相信情绪里直到现在都还觉得，掐我一下，掐我一下，这不是做梦，真的，你的偶像，
谢谢。
谢谢徐继磊，我们不分轮椅的也好，还是不是轮椅的也好，我们只有一个称呼，篮球运动员，加油吧。
我还有一个小小的礼物要送给科比。
哇
哦哇哦 cool
he has a gift to you
alright
什么东西
it's for me
我藏在身后呢、为什么送这个给科比？
因为上海这几天非常热。
洛杉矶好像也不凉快。送这个扇子呀，还有一层含义，因为扇子在中国传统文化当中往往是侠义之士，包括儒雅之士，它好像没有界限，动手的动口的都能用扇子，而且扇子最潇洒的一刻在于，我们相信科比有一天啊，要真拿着这个在 NBA 赛场上，歘一打开，对手老大。没关系。
Yeah, we got no, we gotta practice.
谢谢，谢谢秦旭磊，再一次感谢这个男孩给我们带来的如此了不起的能量，谢谢他。 谢谢你。也谢谢周鹏，谢谢你作为一个体育记者，不仅仅完成了你的体育报道的工作，你也帮助一个孩子真正的完成了一个他的梦想。谢青青，
刚才我看到科比跟秦同学在上面特别特别的感动，看到他们两个站在那的时候，我觉得自己特别的渺小，因为我是一个篮球运动员，从小学开始打球，但是就受了一身的伤，训练过程中我有手骨折过，也现在一直是腰椎盘突出很严重，然后我觉得伤病一直是运动员特别困扰的一个问题，然后想问一下，您在这17年的篮球生涯里，你的极限到底是在哪里？你害不害怕再过10年，你不再是一个篮球飞人，而是一个篮球病人呢？
Yeah, it's injuries is hard because you have to try to train your body to try to minimize the chances that you'll get hurt. But a lot of times, you know, injuries happen. Like I try to eat the right foods. You know, I do all my conditioning, I stretch, and I still tear my Achilles.So it's just a part of the game, and it's one of those things that you just have to let go and have to accept. You know, it's like, you know, in life you can't control everything. There are certain things you just have to let go of, and whatever happens, it happens. And the mindset is if the injury does happen, you have the determination that you know you're going to bounce back from it anyway. You know, so you're not afraid of what might happen.
Thank you. I believe every one.在场边看球的爱篮球的人永远会支持您，也支持你的曼巴精神。
如果抛去今天的这些球员不说，假设我们有一个时光隧道，能让你回到任何一个年代，让你选择一个在你年少年轻的时候你心目中的那些偶像来对阵的话，哪一个人和你同场对垒你会有压力？
To play with, it'sI would love to play with Michael Jordan and Magic Johnson. Yeah. I just feel like, you know, those two players, when I was a kid, they were inspirations for me, you know. So Michael Jordan and Magic Johnson, they were like, you know, they were it. And so I learned a lot from both of them. So I would love to have the opportunity to play with both of them.
大家听到科比在回答的时候，他用的表述方式跟我不一样，我说的是哪一个人可能会让你觉得有压力，但他用的是我想要，我喜欢，我渴望和迈克尔乔丹同场，那是一种愿意去挑战自己人生的态度，从来不会有压力，从来不会有害怕，哪怕就是他年少时代心目中的神站在场上，他也一样接受挑战。这就是今天科比为什么能够成为一个伟大的篮球运动员。我想任何一个记录放在那，不管是乔丹的也好，还是之前更多优秀的 NBA 巨星也好，记录放在那儿，它的意义就在于它是用来让后人去打破的。
Thank you, yes.
来，下一位，李少博。
哎，科比先生，萨哥晚上好。当您在镜子中看到自己的时候，觉得是非常的有自信，因为您是一个非常强壮的、高大的、非常了不起的运动员。但是我看到自己的时候，其实是有点绝望的，因为我觉得我看到是一个非常矮个子，而且是近视眼的男孩，也不敢在篮球场上去做些什么。我们知道，一个人在35岁的时候，其实是一个走下坡路的时候，无论是反应的快慢，还是身体的素质。但是您非但没有想要顺应潮流，相反，还打算去做一件非常了不起的事情，就是再拿冠军。可能我们会觉得这是持之以恒，但是我们也可以会认为这是固执。所以我想问，如果有这么一天的到来，您会觉得是什么让您退役？
When I feel it, I'll feel it. I'll know. I'll feel it right here, and I'll know. I don't want to do it anymore. You know. When I wake up in the morning and I have that feeling of, you know, I don't want to get up at 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the morning anymore.You know, it's not as important to me to win and to try to be the best as it was. And then when I have that feeling, then I'll know, you know, it's just time to step away. But, you know, when I look in the mirror, I just see where I am. I try not to see what I was or what I'm going to be. I try to see where I am right now. And that goes with the strengths, the weaknesses, that goes, you know, with not being able to grow an afro anymore. And that goes with everything that is real and what you are. Because then once you really know who you are as a person and what you can and can't do, then it's very easy for you to make the adjustments and then move forward. But you can't be afraid, you know, to face yourself first and foremost. That's really the key. Once you can face yourself and you can identify your strengths and your weaknesses, then the sky's the limit.
谢谢。八位青年代表，其中有一位李达，还在2011年跟你一起打过篮球。
2011年的时候，我作为科比、慈善、中国行三个中国的大学生代表，跟您打过球。当时我感觉是一个邻家大哥哥的形象走到了我的面前，就是梦想照进现实的感觉。魏如，
来，
对，那个节目组为什么选我来，可能就是因为我的肤色跟您比较近，然后我这边准备了一份自己写的词，中国的诗歌，用中国的书法写的，想送给你。
Important.
Oh, wow.
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 成绩96，年少懵懂，追梦昨朝，十载血泪飘，起落信念不摇，上早上早，王朝号角初聊，江湖风起云霄，前梦半壁徒劳，戎马见天骄，待看霁雨虹桥，恰巧恰巧又逢紫荆王朝。有气势。
哇、wow.
好了，我们亲爱的所有的年轻人，我知道今天这个节目无论我们做多长，可能都很难满足我们现场所有的青年代表观众的期待。刚才在问小纸条问题的时候，我藏起了一个问题一直没问，我想把它放到最后。这个问题是说，科比，如果未来有这样的可能，有这样的机会，你会来中国打球吗？
I think I'll play. I'll come back and I'll play for fun. I'll play for fun. I don't think I'll play professionally. When I retire from the Lakers, that's it. But I'll come back. When I retire from the Lakers, that'll be it for me. But I'll definitely come out here and I'll play, and you know, we'll play with the kids and we'll play with some of the guys from the national team, and we'll just have a good time. So I'll be back.
请记住，在中国的每一个角落的每一个篮球场上，从今天起，因为你的这番话，都会有年轻人拿着篮球站在场上等你到来。我们会等你。再一次把掌声送给科比·布莱恩特。Thank you.
All the best.
我觉得将爱情进行到底啊，我觉得它应该是每一个相爱的人都应该怀抱的一个美好愿望。对于一个人来讲，最大的价值是你正在爱或者曾经爱过，甚或是你还没有爱过，但是你想去爱。我觉得爱所有带来的未来、现在和过去都是美好的感受。